Helen Auma, a refugee from the Democratic Republic of Congo, is earning a living from the management of plastic wastes in Kyangwali Refugee Settlement. She has revealed that the current achievements of employing young girls and boys who are refugees show that it can address many challenges, especially on the side of women in the camp.
It was very, 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 very many. But now when we are seeing our environment, at least it's now clean. Because like those who are drinking water, soda, they're just throwing it anyhow. But nowadays, we are seeing they are collecting it, taking it to Kavule, this one, Kilima, for the store, to the store.
Project, so probably what were the triggers that encouraged us to get into the plastic recycling process? One, we noticed that there was a lot of waste, especially plastic. We noticed that there was a lot of environmental degradation.
According to Alfred Kusima from CARE Uganda, a non-government organization working with refugees in Kyangwali, they are teaching refugees on how to improve their standards of living through growing vegetables and to provide an environmental solution by recycling the already piled up heaps of plastic waste.
Where we're talking about the food system, where we're talking about the communal cooking, and where we're talking about the plastic component, where the three are intertwined to provide a solution on better livelihood, greener jobs, and also environmental conservation. So this is purposed to see about 126,000 households improve their standards.
Alfred says that it is a pilot project under which they are collecting data to inform the next sustainable actions to achieve the improvement of livelihoods, food security, and environmental conservation in the settlement.
And documenting the key learnings from this undertaking and purpose to ensure that at later stage we are implementing through partners and running this as business. And at the end of the day, we need to provide sustainable approaches and mechanisms where community or beneficiaries, in this case, these are refugees and host communities, are at the fore.
The Climate Change Adaption and Mitigation Project is targeting 1,026 refugees and host community members in Kikuube district. Yvonne Awadi, a beneficiary of kitchen gardening, credits the project for helping her to get an alternative way of cooking without using firewood.
Ugandan refugee. Concerning this, it's very helpful. Like right now, I'm cooking beans. I've cooked the beans like at around 7 a.m., but finally they are ready.
The Kikuube District Assistant Chief Administrative Officer, Francis Abite Kaniza Kiva, has called upon the general public and state actors to embrace this initiative in order to promote renewable energy and alternative livelihoods, bearing in mind that the threat of climate change is real and growing.
Well, this is one that surely of now, each and every one of us can tell that the environment fight is getting fragile and delicate. And each and every other day, it is demanding that we be innovative and creative to see to it we beat the drastic changes that are incoming. And particularly for this project, I would love to appreciate that these people are giving us away.
He further called upon everyone to take on the mantle of saving the environment.
Call to the all is one that please, we need to prioritize the fight for the environment. We need to prioritize the livelihoods of our persons. And thirdly, we should take up the mantle. Because when you look here, we've been shared too, that surely the capacity is still low.
In 2009, the President of Uganda passed the National Environment Act, but despite the President's assent to the act, it appears that no efforts have been taken to put it into effect. Story by Godfrey Muhumuza for the news.